three legs of the chair and concentrate for fuck's sake. The more number of attention. Pure beautiful grammar, da. Marketing guru Seth Godin seems to be of the opinion that it takes about 6 years for a startup to get on its feet. But let's be honest, it takes a lot more than that. Unless you've inherited a business that is doing extremely well from your parents, your father, your mother, or you're running a business like this.
Pablo Escobar, the undisputed king of cocaine from the late 70s to the early 90s.
Quite hard to make a mark in 6 years. But yet, hello?
¿Por qué? ¿Qué? ¿Por qué es policía que le tengo miedo a usted o qué, marica?
Pablo. Pablo Escobar.
Como todo el mundo. Podría tenerlo viviendo como un rey, pero ahora ¿sabe qué? Toca matar a su papá, su mamá, sus hijitos, toda su familia.
Success in business to me is like a three-legged chair. There's product, there's marketing, and there's sales. A crack in any one leg sort of cripples the progress of the other two. And yet, the companies that get that magic formula, that magic trifecta right, are the ones who make their way. Fully Filmy is one of the most sought-after brands in India that caters to film audience and most recently sports, with a global customer base within just 5 years of its inception. How did Fully Filmy satisfy Seth Godin's 5-year rule? And more importantly, how did they balance those three legs of the chair and provide that perfect seat for the customer to sit on? Let's take a look. Before I head any further, my last video, my case study analysis on Ranveer Alabadia, aka Beer Biceps, got about 100 views. 100 views might not seem a lot for a lot of people, but it is a huge number to me. It was, if not the best, one of the happiest days of my life. So thank you so much if you watched, and if you want to check it out, I'll link it here. First of all, let's face it. Yes, clothes are important, but movie-based printed t-shirts, I wouldn't categorize them under the most essential service that a human would need. So by default, your target audience is a bit more niche and is trickled down to a much smaller number. So in this case, how do you know if there's a market? How do you know if you can venture into something like this? We'll let the co-founder of Fully Filmy, Ronak Mangotil, answer this for us.
So what me and Seon did was, we had this passion project that we wanted to do minimal posters.
Okay.
Like Hollywood minimal poster, like
Tamil cinema.
No?
Yeah.
So we created this Facebook page called Minimal Hollywood Posters. Very self-explanatory. So we used to take minimal Hollywood posters.
World posters, yeah, right.
Minimal movie posters of like Tamil movies. We used to make. Within like the third series of posters that we put out, it became viral at that time. And the proof of concept is just one Facebook post. Okay, the Facebook post was, so if we make movie merchandise, would you guys buy it?
Uh-huh.
Hundreds of comments, okay, and not a single negative comment. Everyone's like, yeah, fucking yes, we fully support you and shit. Uh-huh. Like, okay, what else do we need? What are we waiting for?
Now that we've determined that there's indeed a market for this, the next step is to cater to as many people as possible, hit every film watching audience as possible. So aside from this basic distinction of Hollywood, Bollywood and Kollywood, there's an even more in-depth distinction on how they cater to the audience, and I absolutely love it. Let's break it down. So fans are usually of two types. There's hardcore fans and there's casual fans. To keep the hardcore fans hooked, Fully Filmy uses three very smart techniques. I think that Tamil Nadu has one of the most strongest meme games of all time. Within seconds of something having a potential of trending, we see tens and thousands of memes already being put up. So there's definitely a market for what's hot, which creates an opportunity to fuel that market. And I think Fully Filmy does a tremendous job of keeping track of trends and striking the iron when it's hot. When Big Boss was at its peak, they came up with this. There's of course the Pulingo song, which sort of became a phenomenon. And most recently, even now, during this quarantine season. Tamil Nadu is known for its celebration of films. So tapping into the minds of this level of fandom works like a treat for companies like Fully Filmy. It's almost like a psychological strategy. Now, if I were to go and attend a buffet, and if there are 50 tables, and each table had one food item that I personally like, I would stroll through each table and I would pick up food and place them on my table. But if the waiter knew that I was coming, And if the waiter knew my tastes and he picked up all those 50 items from 50 different tables and placed them on one single item for me to draw upon from, I would feel more special. I'd eat more with a sense of gratitude towards the waiter. Now, it's still the same food and I'm still eating the same food from those 50 different tables. It's just that the packaging, the way it's delivered to me is different. So that's kind of what Fully Fill Me does with Superstore. They sort of categorize based on heroes so that fans can draw upon from that special roof, making the fans feel almost feel like Fully Fill Me is giving them a tribute with this special category. That is very clever marketing. And the third one's partnerships. Now this one's kind of obvious and this one's been followed by multiple clothing brands. Blue Ribbon, which later became Nike, tied up with Michael Jordan and produced the Jordan sneakers, that which put them on the map later. Puma is now number one in India in sales, and I have a hunch that one man has played an important part in this result. Now Fully Fill Me doesn't necessarily tie up with individuals per se, but they sort of tie up with the talk of the town films, which brings them a lot of exposure. So now that we've done with the hardcore fans, let's move to the casual fans. Now, to me, the definition of a casual fan is someone whose neck isn't too deep into the world of cinema, but who knows enough, who has enough pop culture references to sort of recall the most famous dialogues, the ones who have trended the most. So it almost feels like Fully Fill Me made a list of these dialogues and they've just put them on a t-shirt so that it resonates to these fans. So yeah, a few feel-good t-shirts that would cater to anyone, and then ones that have trended the most. So, have you ever wondered why the most funny guy in your gang gets the more number of eyes on him? Or if you're planning a trip, have you ever found yourself checking who's coming and reassuring if the funny guy's in? Because he gives the most number of memories, it's obvious. So the same concept applies here, only that the funny guy is the Fully Fill Me product. I'll explain. Now, if you were to line up 10 t-shirts and if you were to place a Fully Fill Me product in between, you would most probably go, okay, that's a nice t-shirt, that's a nice t-shirt, that's a cool t-shirt, pointing to a Fully Fill Me product. So right from day one, it almost feels like the co-founders were looking to create something that had a cool tag attached to it, you know what I mean? Now, the wording on a t-shirt can be this long, maximum. So you have to avoid redundancies, you have to make it count with the space that you have. And they somehow find the balance between being witty, being funny, being creative, creating graphically eye-pleasing graphics, and at the same time, they sort of have a declaration of fondness and a fandom for the person they are creating the t-shirt for. So I really found that very, very clever and very impressive, and I would love to have a chat with one of the co-founders about it, just shooting my shot. So ironically, my discovery of the brand was through an SARM interview that Abhishek did a few years ago, and apparently I am not alone. Now I did receive more than 10 replies from women that Kishan Das was the reason, and I purposely left them out because when you're craving for attention from these women and they fanboy over another person. Now, how important is inculcating media in your business in 2020? As our friend would say,
the amount of people running a business in 2020 without a social media presence sickens me to my stomach. Do you even realize that if you don't run Facebook ads, Twitter ads, Instagram ads, LinkedIn, your business sucks? Content.
Content. Content.
That was a Gary Vee impression, if you couldn't say, but it's fine. The point being, I think Fully Fill Me is one of the few brands who've understood the importance of having a media presence in 2020 to run a business, and they've leveraged a significant amount of audience through their social media platforms. Now they do run ads, which is one way of doing it, but me being a YouTube nut, and I'm sure millions of people are out there are also big fans of YouTube, they discovered the brand through social media. They come off authentically as film fanatics. But they, to me, are examples that if you play your cards right and target the right audience, then you can grow your business through social media. This is sort of a brownie point observation, if you will. So I found this technique that they use and I absolutely admire it. So if you take up any interview that they've done in the past and if you look towards the end, you will mostly find that the guests will receive gift hampers from the host, and the guests will be requested to open the gift hamper and possibly show it to the camera. So in the end, they are inadvertently soft selling their product through the audience of the guest, which to me is genius. From a genuine Fully Filmy fan, thank you. I enjoy your products. I enjoy the content you put on YouTube and everything you put out on social media.